Bob Gooding is reading the Safeway commercial in the new news on KTBC radio. When an alarm and radio control sounds, following a procedure long since memorized, Gooding switches on the Conelrad amplifier provided for air raid warnings. A voice tells him to switch to the Conelrad frequency assigned KTBC, 640 kilocycles, and to stand by for further instructions. Gooding immediately calls a radio transmitter to instruct the engineer to switch the KTBC transmitter from 590 to 640 at the prearranged cue. He next secures the Conelrad tape provided according to prearranged plans and threads it on the tape recorder. He manipulates the necessary controls to broadcast the message on the tape over the air. The recorded voice of Jay Hodson advises the audience that this is a Conelrad alert and they're to switch their radios to the 640 frequency at once. Terrell Blodgett, Assistant City Manager of Austin and City Civil Defense Director, enters the room.
This is your Austin Civil Defense Director with an urgent message. Enemy missiles have been reported over Canada traveling in a southerly direction. An air raid warning has been declared in this area. This means that possibly within 20 minutes, the Austin area may be hit by missiles. There will not be time to evacuate. Repeat, there will not be time to evacuate.
At Bergstrom Air Force Base near Austin, the alert has been sounded, and the men of the 4130th Wing scramble for their giant B-52s, according to a well-rehearsed routine. In the huge fallout shelter room beneath the Department of Public Safety building, the state civil defense team is assembling. Dorothy Klukas is combing her daughter's hair when she hears the announcement on the radio. In the distance, she can hear the sound of sirens and whistles. Her first reaction is to call her husband at his law office in the downtown Brown building. She's puzzled by the sound of a busy signal even before she dials. But Dorothy Klukas does not panic. She knows they are prepared, that their home contains a fallout shelter designed specifically for this emergency. She knows that the shelter room is stocked with at least 2 weeks' supply of canned food, bottled water, and fruit juices. Methodically, she begins to close the windows of her house. Carolyn Gilbert is just finishing her letter when she hears the sirens and whistles. She goes to the window of the office to see if there's a fire in the vicinity. None is apparent. Tom Morgan, who works for an advertising agency next door, enters her office with the information that the building manager has just called and instructed him to order everyone from that floor into the basement of the building. Carolyn imagines it's just some sort of civil defense drill, so she leisurely finishes her letter before leaving for the basement. Clarence Phillips and his insurance prospect hear on the television set that the station is going off the air and all viewers should dial their radios immediately to the 640 frequency. Matt Martinez turns on the radio. Ignoring the instructions not to attempt to evacuate, Phillips immediately runs to his car. His purpose, to get out of town as soon as he can. The streets are jammed. Parents trying to get home to their children. Businessmen trying to get to their families. Panic-stricken people trying to get out of town. Roger Clucas pulls into the driveway of his home and rushes inside. No time for greetings. They immediately go over their plan prepared earlier for just such an emergency. Water, check. Food, check. Medical supplies, check. Gas and electricity turned off, check. Battery radio, check. Flashlight, check. They are as prepared as they can be. Fifteen minutes following the alert, the Roger Clucas family enters their fallout shelter room and lock the thick door. Sixteen minutes past the first alert, Carolyn Gilbert is in the basement of the Perry Brooks building. She's not frightened, only irritated. She's convinced that this is just another practice alert. She's fretting because they won't let her leave to call her mother and tell her that she'll be late for lunch. She's considering writing a complaint to the Director of Civil Defense for this useless inconvenience. Drone men playing war. 17 minutes past the first alert, Clarence Phillips is a very frightened man. He's trying desperately to get out of town. The traffic has delayed him. And now he discovers his car is out of fuel and is coasting to a permanent stop. He leaves the car and on foot continues his flight. By now, the streets of Austin are almost deserted. And then at 19 minutes past the original alert. A nuclear explosion occurs 25 miles to the west of Austin in the hills of the Edwards Plateau.
Civil Defense Director. An explosion, presumed to be nuclear, has occurred near Austin. Persons in shelters, stay where you are. Those who are not in shelters should take cover immediately. If shelters are not available, go to a sub-basement. If a sub-basement is not readily accessible, proceed to the nearest building. Close all doors and windows. Stay on the first floor near the center of the house.
At the State Control Center, the weatherman is working over a fallout map. His findings are teletyped to local civil defense directors around the state.
I saw that and I just thought I should share it. That is a public service announcement from 1960 called Target Austin. There was more to it, but I thought that was enough. kind of weird how we were so close to extinction that we had to put out PSAs on how to possibly survive a nuclear attack. Except for the fact that nothing in that would have had those people survive. They would, I mean, they'd live longer, but they'd still be dead. They would all still be very, very dead. And it wouldn't have been just one nuke dropping. It would have been multiple. It would have been saturation bombing. But that was the kind of shit my parents saw. Like, my mom and dad told me they remember doing duck and cover drills. And I think my dad told me, even as a kid, he remembered thinking, how in the hell is this thin piece of wood of a desk going to keep me from getting blown away in a nuclear attack? Truth is, it's not. It is not going to keep you from getting your shit pushed in during a nuclear attack. But hey, just remember, people, we're still 2 minutes to midnight, according to the Bureau of Atomic Scientists, so... midnight being the end of the world. Loading. So how y'all doing tonight? Doing good? You know, it's James's birthday. People should jump on his Twitter and
see, you got one of those fancy volt suits. One size fits all.
Yes, as a matter of fact, they are. Everybody should go jump on him on Twitter. @lonewolf902. Have fun.
Looking for Diamond City?
Oh shit, I should heal up.
Follow the signs.
Yeah, I'm at Diamond City, I know. Huh? Whoa, ho, ho, hey. Missed every bayonet. Butt to the face. Ha ha. Oh, there's no wall there. He's a tough one. Okay. Bitten off more than I can chew there. Alright. Run away. story of my life, though, with games. I'm always such a hard ass, and then the moment I get into a real fight, like, nope, run away.
Can't believe I'm posted outside the wall. Who the heck did I piss off?
I don't know, I'm not familiar. I put that away. Well, what's going on here?
Don't move, Sim. What have you done with the real Riley? Where's my brother?
I swear, I'm not a Sim. Don't shoot, for God's sakes, we're family.
Should I
put the gun down now?
He's a Sim. He'll kill us all.
Kyle, no.
Whoa.
Okay. Show's over. There are no Sims in Diamond City. Hear me? You folks and your damn paranoia.
Move along.
Well, he won't need these anymore.
Hey.
Hi.
He pulled a gun on me. My own brother.
What happened?
I'm not a synth. I told him. I kept telling him. Why didn't he listen to me?
I need a minute.
I need you to step away, Scabber.
I understand, officer. I just want to know what happened.
You got bricks for ears? I said get the hell out of here now.
What's everyone still standing around for?
Oh, fuck
Go
you
back
up.
To your own damn business.
Douche. Oh yeah, I came here for a reason. You.
Arturo.
We can talk about guns, or maybe you want to consider something more up close and personal.
I've got a few minutes to browse.
Self-defense at its best.
Hey, you? I don't know you. Just keep your distance.
Yes.
Keep calm. I'm standing still.
That's exactly what a synth would say. I don't know. Are you really, human?
Human as the day I was born.
Well, you do look human enough. But I'll be watching you. I have eyes like a... They're good eyes. Got it? All right. We can do business, but no funny stuff.
Are you ever going to look up
Let's
from your paper?
What
Here's what we got.
We thought cell phones were bad. What have I got to give you? That. And that. And that. No, I need the key. And one of those. I could sell the other wedding ring. He's dead. Hey, Doc.
Hi.
Prescriptions filled right here. Anything you need.
I've got a few minutes to browse.
Every chem for it.
But you're not the doctor. You're the doctor.
Doc.
Your patient. A new file from Hope. Do you have a legitimate medical concern? Is this about a facial reconstruct?
Yeah. See what's wrong with me, Doctor.
Go over your symptoms with me.
Took a few bad hits recently. Got knocked around.
Severe lacerations, puncture wounds, muscle spasms in the eyes from high levels of stress. Yeah, let's patch you up. And that's that. Anything else bothering you?
No.
Nope.
We're done.
All right. Don't ruin my hard work by dying out there.
Gee, thanks, Doc. It's nice to know you care. How do I get to look like this unit right here? Where's this armor at? Give me this armor. I think I told this story last time, but fuck it, I'll tell it again. My first exposure to Fallout, the Fallout games and all that, was Fallout 3. And I loved the hell out of it. I thought it was really fun. I had a buddy of mine, though, who had played the original, you know, 1 and 2 and Fallout Tactics, and I've played them too. But I was never as big of a fan of those as I was 3 and New Vegas. I really liked New Vegas. New Vegas is probably my favorite. I enjoy 4, but I didn't like how they changed the skills and everything. Well, that's just a personal reference. Fire. Something's on fire. 200 years. It's been burning. You found an enemy, dog? Where? Right there. Right there. Ow, you fucking asshole. My head hurts. My head is cured. What are you gonna do about it? Where are you even at? Oh, there you are. Same spot? Oh yeah, you are. Oh hey. You had a skull. See if we can line up a bayonet charge, boys. Nope, no door. Okay. Yeah, because you're a fool.
Don't think I can pick this.
Can't climb that. Aha! I found a way into your secret base, I think. Oh god, that was a mine.
No sign of him now. Let's go.
Shit. What? Where are you? Why'd you do that? What? Why'd you make noise? I have the eyes of a not completely blind bat. Shotgun shell. Ooh, combat shotgun! Yes! Now I'm no longer Mad Max. Thank you, James, for streaming. Or for sharing. No, I'm streaming. Damn it! I messed it up. I had my one shot. I missed my chance to blow. That is what he says, right? I don't know. I'm a poster child for misheard song lyrics. What is shooting? Ooh, somebody's getting lit the fuck up. Okay. Well. Somebody with a laser weapon, I think. So, oh hey. Ooh, you're not doing so good, pal. God, I gotta stop doing that. Ooh, short hunting rifle. Oh, you're kidding me. Come on. There's no way into this. Alright. Damn you, expert lock. Oh. Hey. Oh, it's Diamond City. Cool. Well, yeah, I didn't go that far, so. What's going on here? Oh. Oh. Well, looks like you guys got it well under control. I'll just mosey on out. Oh, you motherfucker! Did you just shoot my dog? Oh. Oh, yeah. It is on. Oh, that's a mannequin. Time to take my hit of drugs. How did I miss? Ooh. Ooh. Fuck you. Ass. Doing? Oh, I took all my stems. He'll recover in a minute, I think. Oh, no! Baseball. Oh, this is probably where the bomb dropped. Cool. I'm gonna go around that. Oh. Hey, big ass mosquito. Big John Salvage. Ooh. Super mutants. Nope. Just ignore them. And that's what I'll do. Is it my mortal enemies? Oh. Yes. Thank you. Oh, dang it. I think they're in Big John's. Yeah, shit. I don't have nearly enough stem packs for that. Oh, I can level up. I didn't know that. Sweet. Zoom in and out. About this big fancy hospital. Surely nothing could go wrong here. Oh man. Ah, you little fucker. Yeah, that was great. Maybe exploring the wasteland is a bad idea for now. Let's go back to Diamond City, I guess. Oh, let's see here. Probably go talk to Valentine. Detective.
Sometimes you gotta wonder, does anyone fight back? Institute has to have enemies, right?
You mean the railroad?
Told you your luck wouldn't last forever. His ties. Something wrong?
Another stray coming in from the rain. Afraid you're too late. Office is closed.
I know you must be busy, but I won't take much of your time, miss. It's important.
You don't get it. The detective, he's gone. Missing.
Don't worry. I can help. Tell me what happened.
Nick was working a case. Skinny Malone's gang had kidnapped a young woman, and he tracked them down to their hideout in Park Street Station. There's an old vault down there that they use as a base. I told Nick he was walking into a trap, but he just smiled and walked out the door like he always does.
I'll find him. You have my word.
Thank you. Nick should be easy to spot. He's always wearing that old hat and trench coat getup. Please, hurry.
All right, let's see what else. Damn. There is something in the air today. I've been sneezing all day long. Huh. I'm not very charismatic, am I? Okay, good. It's already started it.
I hear there's a fire in the old theater district. It's the latest one.
Everyone else may be closed, but Diamond City Surplus is open 24 hours a day.
Sure. Let's take a look.
Each companion has their own likes and dislikes, except Dog. Dog likes all. Much wow. Great fun. Am good boy.
Here the different raider groups are carving up Concord like Christmas turkey.
I'll take a lunchbox. Yay! shooting my fucking dog? Guess these people ain't gonna learn. Don't shoot my dog. John Wick your ass. Wait, where the fuck am I going? No. This is nowhere near where I'm supposed to go. It's because it's not marked. Oh my god. Okay, well, that was not entirely pointless. I mean, I got some more shotgun shells out of it. Hello, Knight of Cups. How are you? Hope you're doing well. We're just exploring post-apocalyptic Boston. I am on my way to go free Valentine. The ruggedly handsome and handsomely rugged detective who has a bit of a skin condition. And I don't have nearly enough I don't have nearly enough stim packs. Or a- oh god. Oh shoot. Hey. Hey. Oh ho. Hey. Hey. Headshot. Boom. Okay. Oh, you got nothing. Ooh, there's another one. Ooh. Oh god, I'm in a kill zone here. Okay. I need something more effective. Yeah, Valentine is awesome. He's one of my favorite characters. Oh, what am I gonna use? Hunting rifle? I mean, maybe. Okay, douche. Come on. There we go. Gotcha. I win. Victory is mine. You never got close to killing me. I am the greatest. No, there are never enough stim packs. Oh, no. Warrior. Yeah, you're gonna need a fire mission when I'm done with you. Okay, we're gonna you know what, we're gonna switch to that and this. Bye. Ooh. Ooh. Hey, good job, buddy. Man, my dog's a regular turret killer. I let the world pause while I... Whoa! Oh. I thought that was a hooded person who was standing up, and I just about freaked out. Oh. Stealth boy.
Yeah. Ooh, you do not look good, boy.
Only a fucking coward hides.
Well, you know where I am, and you're not coming down here, so I guess that makes you the coward. Bruh. But if you insist, I'll come upstairs. No, no. Don't try to stop me. But first, I'm gonna take all your shit.
That's it.
And that was... Oh, hey. You get wrecked. Oh, those are candles. I thought there was like, ooh, drugs.
Gotcha.
No. Wow. I killed your friends, and you're like, well, nothing to be done, guys.
What the fuck was that? Nothing.
Won't be able to hack this. Won't be able to pick this.
I'm just asking to run across another mine. Oh! Bastard. Oh, hey, I killed two of them. Assault gas mask? That just sounds cool. I am victorious. Ooh, a pack of duct tape. I will need adhesives. For stuff. I don't know exactly what. Canned dog food. Awesome. Ooh, Stimpak. Cat stash. Canned dog food. I'll take that. Always need a board game to keep you busy. And a couple of bottles of wine. You know, a game like this should not have jump scares or anything like that. It's not allowed to. Okay. Did I ever check in here? No. Huh? Uh-huh. I'm sorry to disturb you. Teddy, you go right ahead. I didn't realize this room was occupied. I'm sorry. Alright, enough dilly-dallying. Let us go and rescue Valentine. Hopefully. And not, like, turn into a red mist. Or paste. Alright, off we go. You found something, dog?
Show me.
Ha ha ha. Hell yeah. What were you even pointed at? Whoa. think that hurt me a little bit. Yeah, he's having some Teddy time. Just reading the paper, you know, catching up on the day's events. I've only got 3 rounds. Okay. It's an awkward angle for a vending machine. Wild dogs. Nope, nope. Stay back, boys. Ow, you little bastard. You got this, dog. I see those dogs, and it reminds me of that video of that guy, and he sees the weird looking cat. He's like, "Ma, take the dogs in. There's something out here." He's like, the cat finally gets up to him. He's like, "Blink, motherfucker! What's wrong with you?" New Rataway comfy pillow. I don't want the bone. Give me the shit. Radix. Okay. All right. Need to save Valentine. Need to stop wasting ammo. Yes. Me time is very important in a place like this. Danger common ahead. Huh. Danger is common ahead. I bet that's what it means. Wait a second. Dog, get out of the water. There's something here. Something that should not be disturbed, I think. Yeah. We're gonna go away from that. And instead, we're going to go into the underground. Park Street Station. All right.
I'm telling you, joining Skinny Malone's crew was the best decision we've ever made. Look at this place.
I still say Malone's weak. Caught that detective snooping around, and what does he do? Locks him up. He ain't got the ball.
Damn it, I still keep hitting the wrong button. I also have a submachine gun. Two can play World War II simulator with my Chicago typewriter. Asshole! I'm sorry, buddy. Yeah. worn fedora. I'll totally look like a badass. Wait, did I see the word bomb? No, barb. I think I need that subway token. I think it's like the one in the Capital Wasteland. I think there's a robot down here who will wreck your shit if you don't have a token. God, I gotta remember to stop hitting B. Die Hard reference. Yes. Now I have a machine gun. Ha. 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 I love Alan Rickman so much. I miss him so much. Galaxy News Radio. Oh God, I always do that. I always freaking do that. Heal me. Food and drink.
What the?
Oh, hey. Sup? Need. Oh, shit. That is a lot of dudes. Ow. They are still getting me. Okay. Yeah, get him, dog. Oh, I sneak attacked him? Some dog food. Oh, he just dropped dead. He was like, screw it, I'm done. No more. Burn, baby, burn. Do, 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 do. Burn, baby, burn. Do, do, do. Oh, I have too much. Okay, I'll ditch some things, I guess. I don't guess I need both of these. I don't even have ammo for you, but Huh. Now imagine this with the voice of Todd Howard. It just works. Yeah, Alan Rickman was a treasure. Dirty water. Take. Painting. Paintbrush. Okay. What else? Nothing? Nothing? We got nothing else over here? All right. Oh, I'm not really going with any particular build in mind. I'm just really kind of... Well, I guess if anything, I guess you could say it's like a wreck shop kind of build. Like, just destruction and mayhem kind of thing. A gun-fu expert... I've heard it called. Nope. Ooh. Man. Okay. Ow. Ow. You know, I'm just gonna hit some of that. Armor piercing, yeah. A dinner fork. Why does he have a dinner fork? Is that his preferred stabbing weapon? The one thing that did irritate me about this game when it first came out, though, was that, you know, really it relied upon the players role-playing the fact that they were a parent searching for their missing child, and not what, I mean, all the other, Fallout players that I know of, and that's relentless murder hobos. Oh, hey. Don't kick my dog. God, you are just a bullet sponge, ain't you? Get any other ammo goodies over here. Oh yeah, stim packs, baby. Oh yeah. I guess I turned into Macho Man there for a minute. Ooh, a pack of preserved cigarettes. Because I survived the nuclear explosions, but damn it, I deserve my cancer. Nothing. Okay. Requires key. Okay.
Ooh, aluminum can.
So I got a question. Why the hell would anyone build a vault out of a subway station? This place is like the opposite of airtight.
Because they weren't planning to use it, you moron. We used to pull this kind of con all the time back before the war. Get a bunch of union boys to work some construction job that would go nowhere. Keep everyone on payroll.
I don't know why I'm whispering. They can't hear me. Shit. Do I have a grenade left? I don't. Oh, no, I got a Molotov. Oh, yeah. This is gonna suck for you two. Oh, threw it short. Oh. Oh, yeah. That was bad. For me. Trying to tell me something, like maybe I should use this. Oh yeah, look at that. Look at tons of ammo. Oh. Damn it! Got me. I don't pay attention to my health. Which, eh, whatever. You know, not that big a deal to me. I'm having fun, and that's the important part. Okay. Alright. Oh, but that means I've still got that Molotov.
I got a question.
Here we go.
Why the hell would anyone build a vault?
Hey, boys! Yeah. He had a carrot. Hello! Nope. Damn it, I keep hitting B. I keep hitting B to back out of looting and to crouch. I was about to say, that's a load chance, probably gonna miss. Boom! Headshot. Get wrecked, boys. Nora is in the house. That was a hit. Always take the time to loot. Break his legs. Blow his leg off. Okay. Yeah, they do have some weird shit on them. Like, you wonder, it's like, I mean, but why, though? Old money does me no good. Bobby pin box. Oh, hey, what's up, dude? Oh, but you missed it, Ash. When I first started the stream tonight, I started it by playing an old PSA from 1960 called Target Austin. It was a one of those, here's what you do in the event of a nuclear attack. And, you know, it's stuff that it's like, oh, this is just like peace of mind kind of shit. Like, this is, none of this will actually save any of these people in the event of a nuclear war.
Keep talking, meathead. It'll give Skinny Malone more time to think about how he's gonna bump you off.
Don't give me that crap, Valentine. You know nothing, you got nothing.
Really? I saw him writing your name down in that black book of his. Lousy, cheating card shark, I think were his exact words. Then he struck the name across three times.
Three strikes? In the black book? What I...
Hi, Dino. Bye, Dino. Yes, sir. Take a number.
His name's Sean. He was kidnapped, but I don't know who took him or where they went.
Missing kid, huh? Well, you came to the right man, not the right place. I've been cooped up in here for weeks.
Yeah, I remember my parents, because my parents are both in their 60s, late 60s.
Skinny Malone's no
and, claim. Yeah, that was around the time that they were kids. And my dad was telling me he remembers doing duck and cover drills in elementary school and thinking to himself, how in the hell is this little desk going to save me from an atomic bomb?
Some of them coming.
guns blazing.
Why does that take so fucking long, huh? Hey, Dino, quit razzing that detective and get down here. Where the heck is he?
I used all my... Well... Oh, I don't even have any ammo for it. Lame. Okay, alright. How do we want to do this?
Hey.
Oh, damn it. Miss. Well, that's one down. Oh god, I'm about to die. Not anymore. Drugs. I was about to shoot Valentine. I thought he was one of them. I saw the hat and I go, you son of a bitch. You shoot my dog. Ooh, awesomely astounding tales. Astoundingly awesome tales. Yeah. Yeah, I'll take that.
Who made that noise? Rats. Making me jump.
Ooh, I gotta loosen up.
I'll make this quick!
I don't need 5 submachine guns. I said no one ever.
Rest of his boys are waiting for us somewhere. The name's ironic, but don't let that fool you. He's dangerous. Another locked door. Shouldn't be too hard. Okay.
Yeah, we need to pump those numbers up. Those are rookie numbers.
Once we step through this door, get ready for anything.
Shoot up my guys?
You have any idea how much this is gonna set me back?
I wouldn't be here if it weren't for your two-timing dame, Skinny. You ought to tell her to write home more often.
Oh, yeah. And if you get the perk Bloody Mess, it's even worse. Like, you shoot them with one round and they just explode.
This ain't the old neighborhood. In this vault, I'm king of the castle. You hear me? And I ain't letting some private dick shut us down now that I finally got a good thing going.
I told you we should have just killed him! But then you had to get all sentimental. All that stupid crap about the old times.
Darla, I'm handling this. Skinny Malone's always got things under control.
Oh, yeah? Then what's this lady doing here, huh? Valentine must have brought her here to rub us all out.
Encourage violence. Convince her to leave. The fuck is going on here? And be sarcastic. Oh. I have a very low charisma, so I doubt me convincing her to leave is going to work.
What? At a loss for words?
That wasn't the plan originally, but hey, tempting.
Hey, I'm the one in charge here. You got something to say? Say it to me.
Let's see. Oh, but I do have, what is it called? The Black Widow perk. I've got two ranks in that. So, let's see.
Look at yourself. Darla is playing you for a sap. You're better than this. You're better than her.
No one tells Skinny Malone.
Ah, shit.
I've had enough of this. Time for the hard goodbye.
Oh, God! That was so fast! Oh my God, that hit me so like a fucking freight train. Yeah. Let's just slam two bottles of wine and get into a street fight. Okay, but yeah, let's, yeah, yeah! Get wrecked! Yeah! Oh, you suck! I took old Painless out of the bag, too!
I wouldn't be here if it weren't for your two-timing game.
Should I just start shooting?
By a girl. I'll just run back home to daddy, shall I?
You know what? I'm gonna go ahead and bring old Painless out of the bag.
This ain't the old neighborhood. In this vault, I'm king of the castle. You hear me? And I ain't letting some private dick shut us down now that I finally got a good thing going.
I told you we should have just killed him! Then you had to get all sentimental.
Darla, I'm handling this. Skinny Malone's always got things under control.
Oh, yeah? Then what's this lady doing here, huh? Valentine must have brought her here to rub us all out.
That wasn't the plan originally, but hey, tempting.
Hey, I'm the one in charge here. You got something to say? Say it to me.
Let's see.
This is all just a misunderstanding, Skinny. You know that. You let us walk and we won't come back.
You and Nick shot all of my crew, and you expect to just... All right. You're lucky I still owe him for that time back in the quarry. I'm gonna give you two until the count of 10 before I forget my good manners and start shooting up the place.
What are you doing, Skinny? Kill him!
No, Darla. They get one chance to leave. Skinny Malone's putting his foot down.
My mother was right. You mobsters are all just talk.
Come on, go, Nick, go! Probably hope if I put this away. Where'd you go, Nick? Oh, you went somewhere completely different. Oh, yeah, I found this earlier. Yeah, he's such a noir detective. He's a regular Humphrey Bogart. That's the only noir detective that I know of. God, I love that power armor. I don't know, I'm torn between this and the Operation Anchorage. I can't remember their designations.
Anything so naturally ominous could end up looking so inviting. Thanks for getting me out. How did you know where to find me anyway? Not many people knew where I went.
Your secretary, Ellie. She sent me.
She did? I should give her a raise. Now, you mentioned something about your son, Sean. How he went missing. I want you to come to my office in Diamond City. Give me all the details. Besides, I think you've earned a chance to sit down and clear your head.
I'll meet you there.
See you in Diamond City.
Okay, yeah, so like you were asking earlier, Ash, what I was going for, like, these are my stats. This is how I have them done. I have mostly perception and agility. So, like, I mean, yeah, I'm going to be doing guns a lot. I had, for a moment, considered going the idiot savant route and just maxing out my luck and seeing how far it could take me. But I decided against it. Why? I don't know. I should probably take that. Yeah, it is really iconic. Have you ever seen some of the cosplays of the power armor that people have taken to, like, conventions? It's... Oh my god, it's so good.
Going up.
Yeah, it would be very chaotic. Oh, doggy. Well, I mean, I guess if you know the end's coming. I mean, you know, not my bag, but I don't blame them. But I will take your fancy hat, sir. Poisoned wine. Hmm. try to reset at least. Come on, dog.
No,
there we go.
Ground floor.
Yeah. Yeah, it's one of those, like, you know, it's not my bag, but if you are literally watching the bombs drop, I don't blame anybody for doing it. It's like, because you know that it's not going to be easy from then on out. It has gone from hard mode to hardcore difficulty. And you know what? Some people just don't want to fucking play on hardcore mode. And I don't blame them. Also, too, I mean, death from radiation poisoning. Ugh. Fuck that. I mean, I know it's a dramatization, but all you have to do is watch Chernobyl to see what it does to the human body. I mean, Jesus. Ooh, that was a big bad... Whoa, you're more bad people. Hell, but you're manageable bad people. Oh, hey, you got shotgun. No. Back. Shit, I need to get back to Diamond City. This is the right way. Okay, I think I just ran into something. I thought it was a gunshot, and I'm like, what the fuck? The Warren Theater. I don't know that I would call myself a rookie, sir. Yeah, let them deal with it. Okay. Oh, that was the blood bag. I don't want to go there. Oh, no! No! Damn it! You're everywhere! Fucking super mutants, man. Jeez. Well, at least I found the Trinity Tower.
No.
Oh no! Oh no! Run! Oh no, God! Nope, you stay away. Haha! I've made it. All according to Keikaku. That means all according to plan, in case you didn't know. Yes, I found him. No need to thank me.
Well, it's hard to mistake this mug for anyone else.
You keep laughing at death. Someday, death's gonna laugh back.
Not as long as I got a few friends to back me up.
You saved Nick, this agency, and my job. Thank you.
Happy to do it.
Yeah? Go diving into scary pre-war ruins all the time then, do you? Here. I know an amount was.
I am a pre-war ruin.
Find him, but you deserve a reward. Plus a little something extra. You know, if you're looking for work and don't mind putting on the detective hat, Nick sure could use a new.
Thank you. She gave me a worn fedora.
One case at a time. Our new friend needs our help first. All right, let's get down to business. Take a seat. Make yourself comfortable. When you're trying to find someone who's gone missing, devil is in the details. Tell me everything you can, no matter how painful it might be.
We're looking for my baby, Sean. He's less than a year old. Why would anyone take him?
Good question. Why your family in particular? Why an infant? Someone would be taking on all of his care, and a baby needs a lot of it. What else can you tell me?
We were in a vault when it happened. Vault 111. It was some kind of cryo facility.
You were on ice, huh? More importantly, you were underground, sealed up. A lot of obstacles to get through just to take one person. Anything else you remember?
There was a man and a woman. They didn't say much, but I remember they called me the backup.
So we're talking a small team. Professionals. The kind that know to keep their lips tight when they're on the job. Not sure what the backup means, though. Well, that confirms it. This isn't a random kidnapping. Whoever took your kid had an agenda. There's a lot of groups in the Commonwealth that take people. Raiders, super mutants, the Gunners. Of course, there's the Institute.
Oh, the Gunners. I forgot about the Gunners.
So, you think this Institute is responsible?
Well, they're the boogeymen of the Commonwealth. Something goes wrong, everyone blames them. Easy to see why. Those early model synths of theirs strip whole towns for parts, killing everything in their way. Then you got the newer models, good as human, infiltrate cities and pull strings from the shadows. Worst of all, no one knows why they do it, what their plan is, where they are. Not even me.
Yeah, I've never actually beaten the main story of this game, just like Skyrim. Anyway.
You're a prototype?
As far as I know. Never seen any other synth like myself. There's the older ones that are dumb as rocks and all metal, and there's the newer ones that are almost human. I'm somewhere in between.
Either way, I need to find Sean.
You're right. This
speculation is getting us off track. Let's focus on what you saw. What did these kidnappers look like?
One of them came right up to me. Bald head, scar across his left eye.
Wait. It couldn't be. You didn't hear the name Kellogg at all, did you?
Who is he? Do you think he has Sean?
Way too big of a coincidence. Ellie, what notes do we have about the Kellogg case?
The description matches. Bald head, scar, reputation for dangerous mercenary work, but no one knows who his employer is.
And he bought a house here in town, right? And he had a kid with him, didn't he?
Yeah, that's right. The house in the abandoned West Stands. The boy with him was around 10 years old.
Maybe it's another kidnapped kid.
Yeah, either that or he's got a son of his own. Not a comforting thought in any case. Both of them vanished a while ago. Haven't been heard or seen since. Let's you and I take a walk over to Kellogg's last known address. See if we can snoop out where he went.
Security doesn't really go to that part of town, but you two should still be careful.
I always am.
Can I put on my faded trench coat? Yeah, I'm a badass now.
Newcomer, huh? Talk to Abbott at the wall.
I didn't want Ellie to hear this, but I think you should know. Everything I dug up about Kellogg before his disappearance? Bad news. He's more than just a mercenary. He's a professional. Quick, clean, thorough. Has no enemies, because they're all dead. Except you. 9-1 odds says he's our man. It's more than just you identifying his distinguishing features. The M.O. is all him as well. Leading a small team to kidnap a baby and leaving one of the parents alive for later? Not many mercs in the Commonwealth can pull that off. Here we are.
Won't be able to
keep an eye
this.
Out, will you? See if I can get this open. One heck of a lock. Something to hide, Kellogg? Why don't you give it a try?
No way I can pick this. Nick.
No luck?
Nope.
Need to find a key. Stubborn lock, ain't it? See that platform in the distance, near the city entrance? That's the elevator to the mayor's office. Why don't you go ask around there? I'll stay here and see if I can jimmy this lock.
Yeah, I hear the endgame choice is kind of meh. There you go, dog. My problem with a lot of RPGs, though, is just that I... It's just that I have a tendency to start playing them, and then I'll stop and be like, well, what if I do it this way?
You ever think maybe you could get a man's attention easier if you use softer words, honey? Maybe shout a little less.
Damn! You gonna take that shit?
Fair with a certain airheaded blonde.
Oh, look who it is. What brings you to the mayor's office, huh?
I'm trying to break into somebody's house.
I'm trying to track down a man named Kellogg.
Interesting. That's the guy who bought the house in the abandoned West Stands. had that kid.
If you are done crowding the reception area, Miss Piper, the mayor needs to make time for more responsible citizens.
I was just leaving anyway.
The mayor's receiving visitors, as long as they aren't members of the press. Did you need help?
I need to talk to someone about Kellogg's old house in the West Stands.
Mr. Kellogg's residence? He left town a while ago. We foreclosed on the property and locked it up. If there was something belonging to the man that you have a claim on, you could ask the mayor to hear you out. No guarantees.
Yeah, I have a claim. My kid!
I can feel the gears of bureaucracy grinding me up already.
Like grist in the mill, honey. Good luck.
No funny business around the mayor. Got it?
Ah, yes. I remember you. Our new arrival. I wish I was in your shoes, getting to see our glorious city for the first time. How can I help you?
The man named Kellogg used to live in the city. I need to search his house.
I see. Well, whatever reasons you have, I take my citizens' privacy very seriously. Even after they've left. I can't allow you to invade someone else's home. That's all there is to it.
Please, Mayor McDonough. This man, Kellogg, kidnapped my baby. I need to find him.
I see.
Shut up, bitch.
I'm sorry, but however horrible the crimes this Mr. Kellogg may have committed, your word alone isn't hard evidence.
I understand. You have rules. Maybe for the right amount, you can bend them a bit?
What? How dare you? I'm the mayor, for God's sake, not some thug for hire.
Shit.
So that's...
Pray that for anything.
Fine. Thanks for nothing.
I know it's disappointing, but I have to think of all the people of Diamond City, not just the needs of one person.
I'm probably gonna come back and kill you later, so... Yeah, no hard feelings, bruh. What's over here? Is this your personal space? Am I invading it? Oh, I've never actually seen one all together. Giddy up, Buttercup. I was actually really bummed out to hear that in the Fallout universe, horses are extinct. It's like, oh, that sucks.
Hey, Geneva.
I'm sorry, but you're not getting that key for me. Why do you want it so badly anyway?
Please. All I want to do is find my baby. The man who owned that house.
Yep, see you later, man. Have a good one. Him.
I've heard the sob stories before, so save them.
Maybe we can reach an agreement. I just happen to have a pile of caps here.
A gift? For me? Oh, how generous. There I go again, leaving a key out on my desk and forgetting to put it back.
Yeah, I know, boy, it sucks. Yeet! We can go bust up Kellogg's pet head real quick, and then we'll call it there for the night.
Super Salon can give you the hairstyle of your dreams.
Hey,
in we go.
Let's take a look around. Kellogg must have left something behind.
Yeah, he must have left something. A hot plate, of course.
Small to you. Think of a guy like Kellogg would think big. Nothing here. Did you check out that desk?
Ha! Button!
That's one way to hide a room.
Gwinnett Stout Beer. 44 caliber bullets. Cigars. San Francisco Sunlights.
Interesting brand. Won't lead us anywhere on its own, though. Hit in the head? I can relate.
Why does he have a mannequin in his... That's weird. Anyway.
I wonder if dog meat could pick up the scent.
Say, that's not a bad idea. Some dogs out there in the Commonwealth can track a man for miles. Well, dog meat seems eager for the job. Why don't you let him have a whiff? See if he picks up on the trail. Before you head out, I know this is personal business. If you have to face Kellogg on your own, just say so.
I want you with me on this, Nick.
All right. Let's get that bastard. Your show from here on out, okay? You say jump, I'll say how high.
All right. Oh, missiles, yes. Don't worry, Kellogg. In the next installment, I'm gonna wreck your shit. Yeah, we'll go ahead and save. You know what? Let's see if we can find somebody to raid. I'm gonna see real quick. There's gotta be somebody on. Meanwhile, while I do that, enjoy some music.
Said all the gentlemen, obviously. The madam has the cutest personality. And think of all the books about DuBarry's looks. What was it made of the toast of Paris? She had a well-developed personality.
What did Romeo see in Juliet, or Pierrot in Pierrette, or Jupiter in Juno?
You know. And when Salome danced and had the boys entranced, no doubt it must have been easy to see that she knew how to use her personality.